slept through the night, and now I'm going to keep looking. And would you look at that? I found a rubber in the tree. Right here. They're really easy to see. They have these little spikes in them, and they look different, obviously. And I'm going to need these saplings. Rubberwood trees have these little orange dots on them, and when you break them, you get sticky resin, and you can use that for a lot of industrial things. They're pretty fun and very helpful. Back home. I always gotta look at the mini map. I was looking at the wrong direction. Wow. I missed. Alright, now that I'm back, I'm going to plant our sticky resin trees right up here. Once these grow, there's an easy way to make them more compact and easier to use. The plants that we grew the other day grew already, and you get leaves from them, which I don't see the full use of. But we also have flax, which I think is from a different game. It is pretty useful. I'm gonna put these indigo flowers here. And then I'll just store everything in this chest here. I'll put the clay, the quicksilver, all of this, not that, and the mine stuff and all over here. And then I'll show you what the redwood blocks do. I don't need this, I don't need that. There we go. So now, if you take... and also, project tables hold items in them, so you don't have to go away when you need them. But up here, I'm just going to place another crafting table, just so if I need another component to this part, I can take it out and use that. And I'll make redwood planks. And that makes a barrel. Now, I'm just going to turn all of that wood into barrels, because barrels are really useful. And I'll show you how useful the project table is. All I have to do is press shift, and it makes the most that it can. And then it saves one extra, which I'll just use. Now I'm going to actually make me and Fort a nice little bed. Nope. I'll put it right there. And then these barrels are pretty useful for storing. Let's just use dirt as an example. You place these down. They have like little divider signs, division signs. We don't really need this whole wall here, but if, if I take a piece of dirt and or a stack of dirt, it saves one stack in there. Now, you could put one more stack, three stacks, tons of stacks of dirt in there. You could put like I think over 64. And then you right click it, and it shows that you have 205 pieces of dirt in there. And then you left click it, and it takes out a full stack. But if you press shift and you hit it once, it takes out one block. So if you don't really want a full stack, you don't need to take a full stack. It's pretty useful. You could just build a whole wall of all the materials that you could possibly need. Like one for tin, one for bronze, one for iron, one for refined iron. It's all really cool. The next thing I'm going to make is I dropped my mouse. I need a generator. It's not that hard to make. It's just an RE battery, an iron furnace, and refined iron. An iron furnace is pretty easy. It's just iron in a, just like a chest or a normal, or you could save one, three pieces of iron and put just a shape like this and put that there, which I'm not going to do because it's not that much more expensive. Let me just count this out. And then I'll need to cook. And I'll put 6 in here. And then 2 in there. And it'll cook. You know what that does. I don't need to explain.